that's why all the candidates, if we're taking care of other business, hopefully have our budget together, and if not, that's what I told you, okay? All right, so we'll table, matter of fact, let's just table our budget until October meeting, okay? Committee report, Dr. Marks.
Okay, there's an updated election calendar that was on the back table. Please be sure that you get a copy of this, because these are the elections coming up this year and in the next year. We have a very busy schedule that will not let up. We really need to focus on being aware of these dates and making sure that we get Democrats out and voting. It's the responsibility of the party to make sure that we have the voter turnout. It's the responsibility of the candidates to persuade folks who will vote. Our focus has to be on getting out the vote. Qualifying for municipal elections is going to be coming up Monday, August 19th at 8:30 in the morning, continue with Friday of that week at 4:30. At that point, we will know who the candidates are running for the municipal elections. We hope to hear from all of those candidates at the September 9th meeting on that candidate forum that's being organized by Dr. Tan. You then have the dates of early voting for the municipal election. The last day to register to vote is October the 7th. Early voting starts on October the 14th. That election over on November the 5th, unless we need a runoff, in which case there will be runoff, and the voting for that will take place on December the 3rd, with early voting the 3 weeks previous to that. I assume the camera's back on while we're talking about
it. It is.
Then in next year, we'll have the presidential preference primary. The deadline to register for that is February 24th. We'll have 3 weeks of early voting for that, including at least a Saturday voting. We're going to have to work with the Board of Elections to see if we can also do some additional Saturdays and Sunday voting as well. Then the qualifying for all of the offices for next year takes place the first week of March. And we need to be sure that we have candidates running for all of those positions. We cannot let a position go by default. We really need to encourage folks to run for all of those positions, and they're listed on the back. So a lot coming up. Next year is a big year, but this year is just as important a year, because the municipal elections really determine who's going to be the mayor, who's going to be on council, who's going to be one of the other municipalities. This makes a real impact on what happens here in Valdosta and Lowndes County. Let's get out. Let's make sure we get out the vote, and we've got a lot of work to do. So, any questions about upcoming elections? Yes, sir.
What's the elections office view or reasoning for not having Saturday voting on municipal elections?
My understanding is that the city, that has to be requested by the municipality that is having the election. My understanding is that the city talked about that, but did not make a request to the Board of Elections. Is that correct, Mr. Jones?
Probably nothing to be done this time, but
yeah.
I find it very ironic that on the state and national elections, they have Saturday and Sunday voting, but on the municipal, they don't have weekend voting at all.
The only mandatory weekend voting is there's a mandatory Saturday for state and federal elections, and additional beyond that mandatory Saturday, and including Sunday, because there's actually more folks voting on Sunday than voting on Saturday. So we need to make a presentation to the Board of Elections, and we'll do that to make sure that we have that weekend voting.
So that's City Council's job to request that, you say?
It's the city's responsibility to request it. You know, Ms. Julie said it wasn't discussed by the City Council. I don't know what the city talked about. Any other questions? Thank you very much.
We just echoed something with Dr. Mark just so that, I know we got quite a few running for different offices during this November election, but for next year, remember our last midterm, there were eight unopposed seats that the Republicans just walked right into because we didn't run nobody. Folks, we got to know somebody out there that can qualify, like Dr. Mars said. We got to put somebody in the constitution and let us walk in. We can do that. We can win some things, but we just got to put the people in and get them out there and support. I know Dr. Mark talked about elections. He kind of touched on qualifying, and we already got, a slate full of pretty good for this coming up November. Wouldn't you say?
We've got good folks running for mayor. We've got both Cody and Sonny Bakers running for re-election. This afternoon, Tim Carroll announced for re-election, and he could use some opposition.
Yeah.
We need a Democrat running for that city council position.
I'll say that one, yeah, we need somebody running, give him a good challenge, just so they just walk in. So just think about it, and our membership, now Vice is qualifying, he's out because he wasn't feeling well, he didn't want to come to the room and contaminate the whole room, so I quickly gave him an excuse not to really have to show up tonight. Membership, she's not here, but we definitely want to continue to try to improve on our membership, trying to get people to come to our meetings, join the organization, join the Democratic Party, and try to grow as much as we can. And when we start growing, we just can't just lay back and sit on our hands and let other people go to work. We all have to work. It's not an I thing, it's a we thing. Okay? So we're getting there. I have a important position I need to try to fill, and I'm asking, if you just think about it, I know somebody, public relations. We need a public relations person, somebody to get the word out to Lyons County about Austin.
Yes, sir. Information on the public relations.
Hmm?
Do you have some information on the public relations position?
I don't have them, but I can get y'all to get what you need. Okay, I took care of that. If you know of anybody, in case I'll convince him. Okay, number seven. Okay, I'm sorry. Yes, ma'am.
Sir Chair, is that public relations position volunteer?
Yes, ma'am.
I think that's important that one knows that. It's a volunteer position.
It's a volunteer position. Thank you. Okay, number seven, boots on the ground. Boots on the ground means just what it says. Starting September the 15th, if you look at your calendar, on the ground and say, and the money out of his mind. But if you've gone to church and said everything, so that afternoon, that's a Sunday afternoon, we're going to start knocking on doors. And the reason I picked that day, it wasn't because of the date we wanted, but as a motorcycle unit, and Valor, so they're gonna have a little rally that Sunday afternoon. And, you know, kids like motorcycles, grown-ups like motorcycles, so I told this lady, and she said, well, what if we ride in front of you all and kind of stir up the neighborhood and walking down the street? All the men are gonna be out there anyway, so sounded good to me, so we decided to tag along with them. We're knocking on doors starting the 15th of September. This will be the only Sunday that we'll do this. All the other times will probably be on Saturday or one day during the week or late in the afternoon, that type of thing. But we got to knock on some doors. We need to knock on doors if we're going to try to win this election that's coming up. We're going to turn that courthouse blue. We're going to knock on some doors. We're going to talk to some people. doesn't know the support to get out and vote. And that's what the whole purpose of boots on the ground is. We're knocking on doors starting at 15th, but that would be the only Sunday that we'll do it. The rest of the time we'll be doing the weekdays and on Saturdays, sitting up at different locations, trying to do it. And this past week alone, we actually had Saturday, I know for a fact, we had 3 voting booths for Saturday. And prior to that, we had that Friday, we had one. Saturday we had 3, Friday we had 1, the week prior to that we only had 1. But we had, but the problem is the same people. If I was to get the people that work on for the last 3, last 4 voting booths, it would be the same people standing there. Dr. Tan, Dr. Gill, Tyler Tucker, Catherine Grant, the same people. Same people just can't. I'm burning them out. They get away. They see my name, they don't answer the phone. They know I want something. You know, so we. It's not just one or two people. We need everybody. If you just give 2 hours, I worked up the 10 all day Saturday. All day Saturday. It was hot out there. It was hot out there Saturday. So, but if we have people to volunteer, take 2 hours, an hour. Just give some of your time. That's what's gonna get us over, because we may not get but maybe 2 or 3 registered voters. But guess what? Hopefully that 2 or 3 will go talk to somebody else. I think they got, how many of y'all got Saturday time?
I know it was more than 10.
Yeah. So we get 1 or 2 when we go out. But we just need everybody here to volunteer so we can camera. Someplace. I know we got the Honeybee Festival going on. We got that covered. But we did need people to go there and help and work out the plan. Just can't be 1 or 2 people. Can't be 1 or 2 people. So we just need your help with that. Number 8, Senator Williams. Senator Williams will be here on October the 9th. She's a state. Chair lady for the state of Georgia for the Democratic Party. There's a problem why she didn't come down last month, but she will be here on the 7th of October. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, can we backpedal for 1 minute? Do we have a time established for the boots on the ground?
Boots on the ground at 4 o'clock.
Thank you.
Thank you. Number 9 is another volunteer position.
I have questions.
Yes, sir.
When Senator Williams is coming on October 7th, are you taking care of her accommodations?
No.
Are you involved in that at all?
No.
And expenses associated?
Other than I shouldn't have moved in. I'll take a dinner from her staff, but other than that, she said they're a paper owner, if they stay. But I assure her that if she comes down, what? Question was, do we have to take care of accommodations when Senator Williams comes down on October the 7th? The answer is no. I talked to her assistant. She said that they were going to come down. They would go back. I assured her that she'll be out there by 8:15.
She'll be coming down
by October meeting. We'll let her go first. Excuse to get back on the road, that's fine. But they said they'll take care of their own accommodation. Because we have already put out this money once, and they know this. So I don't think they're going to try to do this. Any more questions?
Mr. Chairman, I noticed on the meeting, the minutes from the meeting, that discussion of whether or not the flag, I wasn't here, whether or not the flag.
You can't have a name change on the plaque.
No.
You have to redo the whole entire thing. And besides that, we're gonna get something to do with the plaque. I'm just gonna step against everything that's been said. The plaque that I had donated by Harmon's Trophy Shop will go to Central Reconditioning. plaque is donated. The Democratic Party will not pay a penny for that plaque. Now, if the Democratic Party had to pay for the plaque, okay, but the party didn't. So it was donated, meaning it was given to us. And the way the plaque is, you cannot take a name off because it's one big sheet. There's one big sheet on a piece of wood. The only way you take that off, take the whole sheet that metal they put on it and throw it in the trash can and do another plaque. So if she's coming, we're going to say we appreciate it. That's her loss. But we will give her that plaque.
Now, I actually hate to bring this up, but if she didn't come and do what she said she would do, then why should we send her, even if it was a donation?
I think the responsibility that we discussed, if you came down and said, we would know this. We discussed this at our executive meeting. The reason why she didn't come because she did not want to speak for the Republicans on the ticket. So that's why she didn't come. And all we had to do was vote not to have a Republican on the ticket. And she would have came. Except if you voted to allow the Republican to speak on the ticket, that's why she didn't come.
That's not
and that meeting was held at the executive. I came off a vacation one day to hold an emergency meeting. And we had that meeting where we voted on that the Republican would speak. And so when that happened, I notified Senator Williams' office, and she said she would have come. And this is the day she told me she sent, actually sent 2 days. But the first day she signed was Labor Day weekend, which was a bad weekend. So the next day is October 2nd. Okay? Yes, sir.
Does this volunteer plaque have a date on it?
It has the date of July the 2nd. I'm pretty sure it does.
For the one she didn't come to?
Right. We're just going to show what she just missed. I'm not going to try to change the flag. I'm not going to ask Tom and Kirk to change the flag. I'm just going to do it just like this.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, sir.
I'd like to make a motion. Do not get the flag on.
I'll just tell you what we're going
to do. I second that motion if the motion is on the table.
But Andy,
anyway,
I'm the chairman. You're a chairman, you're on a dictate.
Moving on, next.
I think at the last executive meeting, we voted to table this until this meeting so that others would have more input on it if possible. But I see that there is, because we established that at that point that we can vote on something like that.
Yeah.
So if he has a motion on the table, we can either go with the motion and follow through. If the majority of this body don't want to give it to her, then that's what we need to follow. It was donated, so it won't cost us anything if she doesn't get it.
All in favor of giving the plaque, let me see the show of hands.
Well, we got to follow the motion.
Oh, we got a motion. Can I get a second?
Second his motion not to give it to her.
Okay. Motion is saying we're not to give her the plaque. All in favor, let me see the show of hands.
The not to give it to her.
Okay. All in favor, give her the plaque, let me see the show of hands. Put the count.
Keep your hands up.
All in favor of not, let's do this. All in favor of not giving her the plaque, let me see the show of hands.
Please, everybody can vote.
Two.
If you got a member.
Executive committee members, 25 members only voting.
One, two, three.
Okay, let's get clarification from Mark.
Committee members only vote.
Okay, we're going forward. On this last round, you just said.
Yeah, you're a committee member.
I know I'm a committee member. I've been on for 10 years. But my question is that what was your last statement? Because some people looking around to see if they can or cannot vote. That's why I should specify if this can be committee vote.
Committee vote on the right.
Okay, well then. Please go back over again.
All in favor of not giving up the flag, committee member, you see the show.
My resignation is effective at the end of today's meeting.
So we got one, two, three, four, five, six. All in favor? Hold up a sec. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
All in favor, give it to them, this is your hand.
1, 2, 3.
Okay, let's go and give it to them. Okay, moving along. Number 9. Need a fundraising chair. Okay, somebody chair the fundraising committee. We had Constantine James, but Constantine James was elected as assistant treasurer. We need to leave it like that. Constantine does a good job. I think she'll do a good job at both of them. But even as such, how do y'all feel about it? If there ain't a problem, but letting it stay like it is, then the whole vote position. Well, she just said the only thing she was aware that she was doing, she was just spearheading the body. But I think she'll make a good chair for she's a hard worker.
It's a volunteer position, so I think we need to ask her whether she's willing to continue as the fundraising chair. I don't think there's a problem with her serving as the assistant treasurer and the fundraising chair, but it is a volunteer position, so we need to find out whether she would like to continue.
Okay, we'll check her on that, so we'll just table that to our next meeting. Number 10. And it's that time of year again that we get ready to talk about our Christmas party. We just don't want to wait till the last hour, unless it's last year. We'll do that so we get somebody to spearhead that. Can we get a volunteer to set up a Christmas party for the year that time? They raise their hand one time.
This would be considered a fundraiser?
This is also a fundraiser.
So then it correlates then back to whether or not Constantine is going to assume that position. Am I correct? It correlates back to whether or not Constantine is going to assume that position as fundraiser chair.
Okay.
I'm asking.
Yep, she's going to, she wants to remain in the position. I guess we'll hold off and let her make her decision. But we did need just didn't even think about the Christmas party. Last year we had it at Jenny McGann's house. And I think we'll be a little larger this year, a little bigger participation this year to have that many people going into her house like that. I'm not sure. But we'll hold off on that until I talk with Jane and see if she sees it. Number 11, on Saturday, August 10th, which is this coming Saturday, there's training in Tiflin. If anybody wants to go, it's RSVP, then let them know if you want to go on team. So I guess they'll arrange for seats. And can you get a flyer for that?
Yes.
This is it. Does everyone have one?
Yeah. It's on the back table back there, information. There's a lot of training been coming up here lately, so. If you want to go to that, just RSVP that and check it out and go from there. Number 12 is there'll be no meeting in September. September 2nd, our normal meeting date, there will not be a meeting because of the holiday. But we will have a meeting on the 9th of September. And we're going to turn this part over to Dr. Tain. We're very kind of explaining to you what's going on.
Thank you, Chair.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Well, I'm glad that you guys are doing fine. I'm just assuming that you are. I met with my team on this evening that's going to coordinate this debate. It is not going to be a forum. The team that I work with will be comprised of George and Tyler and myself. We're organizing, spearheading this event, and we've decided tonight that we're going to have an actual debate. We're excited about it. We want you to be excited about it, too. Of course, it's going to take place on September 9th. I want everyone to know that all the candidates will be invited to the debate. And we're going to leave all the treats.